Hi friends, I hope you're all doing well, and this is a lovely place that I'm here. It's in Goa. So today I would like to make a video on one of the rare twin flame signs. So before I go into the sign, what the sign is, I would like to read to you an excerpt from a book. Okay, and I learned about this from one video by an astrologer named Santosh Bonashi, and in his video on twin flames, and I'll put the link down, whatever it is. It is about white tantra, I think, and sex of ascension versus sex of descension and twin flames. So I'll put the link down below. So this is one of the signs. I'll make a separate video on more signs that I know. So I'll just read it, I think. Okay, so the author of the book is Thomas H. Burgoyne on twin flames. Okay, and this is an excerpt taken from the video by Santosh Bonashi. Okay, so I'll read it. Okay, just pay attention for the signs of twin flames. On page 45 it says, the twin souls are related to each other primarily as brother and sister, and finally as man and wife. And I will explain to you why this is. Their true meeting place is the plane of embodied humanity, which is ascended earth. But during the present cycle, very few of these spiritual unions take place. That is changing right now. This spirited love is the outcome of their divine relationship and should never be set aside or crushed by any worldly considerations. Okay? So here is saying it's a spiritual love, it's not a 3D relationship. The soul never makes a mistake when claiming its own. Now this is written by Thomas H. Burgoyne, okay, in his book on page 45. The soul never makes a mistake when claiming its own. Should circumstances in life or any other material considerations prevent their rightful union, the fact that they have actually met will constitute an invisible connection, a spiritual rapport which no earthly power can break. So yeah, this relationship is really not about the physical aspect so much, although it is, but mostly it is not, because it's a spiritual relationship. And what he's talking about, the spiritual connection, is the Merkaba activation, because in the Merkaba you and your twin flames are one. Okay, so you are one with your twin flame, so there is a spiritual connection to your twin flame. Okay, so in 3D you are one body, but in 5D you are together. Okay, and deep down in the secret chambers of the heart, the image of the loved one will be treasured up, and its continual presence will poison and corrode everything which pertains towards an ephemeral affection for another. This is true, because he says, because when you meet your twin flame within a year or two or three sometimes, you know, all attraction for other people falls away, and it happens gradually. And the way it happens is because you integrate your masculine aspects, so the codependency reduces inside you. So next, if a female should marry under these circumstances, now this is really interesting, and become the mother of children, it will frequently transpire that the actual germs of spiritual life will be transmitted by this absent one. So your 5D twin, okay? The external husband only provides the purely physical conditions for the manifestation of the spiritual offspring, the true Lord. The spiritual bridegroom is the real father. And very often the child born will resemble the image of its true parent. Okay, so if you've met your twin flame, okay, and if you've had the astral merge, then when you marry somebody else, your children will probably look like your twin flame. Okay, because the actual, because the DNA has merged, right? You have this DNA merge. So of course any offspring that you produce will look like your real partner, which is your twin flame. Okay, Man and wife should harmonize both in physical temperament and in magnetic polarity. Okay, and Santosh Panashi in his video stresses on this. And I will put a link to his video because it's some really cool information. Okay, and he's a very good astrologer and I'm thankful to him for sharing this information out for the Twin Flame community. I'm very thankful to him. Discordant unions are the harbingers of sorrow, crime and disease. Sexual union between inharmonious souls creates wickedness. It's the discordant polarities of the astral constituents. Okay, so this is what Santosh Banashi says in his video while reading from the book by Thomas H. Burgoyne on twin flames. Okay, so now here in the first paragraph, when I heard this yesterday, I was so stuck because I immediately knew that this was a sign, because here it says that twin souls are related to each other primarily as brother and sister and finally as man and wife. And this sign, I knew it before listening to this video because I have this sign in my union. My twin and my brother's birthday is on the same day. So my real brother and my twin flame, both of them, they have their birthdays on the same day. So this sign, when I met him 1.5 years back, this sign really caught me. Okay, and that time I had just I was like not in acceptance of this whole phenomenon, but when I thought about this sign, that is when I realized that, you know, there is something going on over here. And it's like after 1.5 years I realize now that this is one of the signs which is mentioned in the book by Thomas H. Burgoyne on twin flames. Okay, so he mentions about this sign and I was not aware of it till yesterday. Okay, but in a way I was aware of it because I had experienced it. So this is the rare twin flame sign that I wanted to talk about. All right, now this is an excerpt by Thomas H. Burgoyne. And then we have another spiritual master which I have mentioned in my previous video. His name is Yogananda. In his description of twin flames, he also describes twin flames, you know, and he has similar views on twin flames. I'll read certain excerpts from Yogananda's book. It's called The Second Coming of Christ. Okay, so up till here I think you all understood what the sign is. Twin flames are from the same soul. Okay, so that's why they have this, like, you know, like me and my twin flame, his birthday is on the same day as my brother's birthday. Okay, because and they look similar also. Okay, so this is one of the signs. It's a very strong sign and it is mentioned in that book. Okay, and now this is what Yogananda has to say about twin flames. In the verses, Jesus cites the original divine law that marriage should be union between soulmates who are attracted to each other by divine magnetism and not by animal magnetism of sex. Okay, to understand rightly the meaning of these words about marriage, divorce and adultery, one must know the profound metaphysical truths concerning the union of twin flames. Okay, and then he expresses here, in a sense, the soul is perfect and complete and is a reflection of God's ever existing, ever conscious, ever now bliss. But when it incarnates, it takes on the dualistic nature of creation, outwardly expressing primarily either a masculine or feminine, positive or negative half of its essence. This is why it's said that in Oriental scriptures that when God reflected his consciousness in created form, they became half souls. By taking on through identification the qualities of the manifested units of creation, positive or negative, reason or feeling, impregnated male or female, these dual qualities are soulmates of each other to be eventually reunited. Okay, so now at that point, this was many decades back. Okay, at that point the term twin flame was not there. Okay, so Yogananda used the term true soulmates to express the same thing that we know today as twin flames. All right, so then I'll read something more. It is clear from Jesus's references to Genesis in these verses that he was citing the law of soul, true soulmates. The immutable law of spiritual love which should motivate all marriages. This was, as Jesus emphasized, the divine law at the beginning, that for every true man there was a true woman, and each one who lived rightly on earth would automatically be drawn together in soul companionship with the mate by the operation and decree of this law. He is talking about the law of polarity and magnetism. True marriage serves as a spiritual device for perfecting the full expression of souls and freeing them to God by proper union, a process of evolution through which souls projected away from God into creation would be brought back. So here Yogananda explains that twin flames are a spiritual marriage which leads to liberation. Okay, so it's a process where, you know, you come back to your source. Alright, so I've read to you three excerpts from Yogananda's book on Second Coming of Christ. Okay, just bear with me because I'm reading here from the book. Okay, one last one. Divinely enlightened beings of advanced Vanish civilizations in higher ages unknown to history lived more natural spiritual lives in harmony with God's will. Men and women were mated rightly. Okay, so there was no cause or necessity of divorce. But with the decline of civilizations in cosmic eonic cycles of rising and falling, people became materially minded due to the misuse of their will and reason. Owing to the impurity of their hearts, they could not draw to themselves the right soul companion. Yeah, so actually what happened is, as the level of consciousness fell down, we couldn't recognize our twin. Okay, and this was not so much an individual thing as it was about the collective, you know. It was a collective plan to go down into the darkness. Okay, now if you were to maintain a very high level of consciousness through spiritual practices, you could still magnetize your twin flame. But you know, it's really rare for twin flames to get united in this physical plane when the level of consciousness is full. The level of consciousness has to be really high on the planet for twin flames to reunite, which is happening now, because now we are in the age of Aquarius. Okay, now Earth's Schumann resonance is rising. Now we have the crystalline grid in which twin souls are supposed to ground. Okay, so it's a completely different story right now compared to the past ages where twin flames couldn't reunite. Okay, and most of them who were on the twin flame path, they would meet their twin flame. Even Yogananda describes the story of this man. You know, they would meet their twin flame, they would have the inner union, and then they would just walk the plain old spiritual path, you know, the Kundalini rising path, the crown chakra awakening path. So it was like that in the previous ages, but right now it's possible because of the huge movement in consciousness, the huge collective consciousness rising, because Earth is ascending when the planet itself makes a decision to ascend. Okay, then that's a whole new story. And twin flames are called in large numbers right now to help the planet ascend. Otherwise, we wouldn't be called, right? And not only twin flames who have been here are reuniting, but starseed twin flames, you know, starseeds, twin flames have incarnated for the first time here on the planet, okay, to help the planet rise. So most of the twin flames are going to reunite, okay, at this point. It is meant to be. But for that, each twin flame has a schedule. You have to do the amount of work, you have to do the amount of contribution for the planet, and then you usually have your reunion. However, it's not about the external reunion. It's about coming to the stage where you don't really feel anything missing, okay? You're not supposed to really feel anything missing. So I hope you like today's video. It was on a rare sign of twin flames, because twin flames are like two peas in the same pod, okay? And I was really, really shocked yesterday when I watched that video and I realized what he had said, the words which he had said. So I thought I will share this because this is a very rare twin flame sign and it's a very powerful twin flame sign. Because before you get on the twin flame path, you're supposed to be sure of yourself, all right? Doubts happen, but it's the process of coming to that place where you're sure. Doubts happen with me also. But most of the people, what they do, they're not sure that whether this person is twin flame or not. So they will stay in their marriages, they will stay in their old relationships and claim that they are on the twin flame path. You are not on the twin flame path. Okay, you are on the security safety path and unsure path. Okay, because if you were sure and if you were committed to your twin flame, whether this person is a real twin flame or not, if you are committed to the twin flame path, now everything else falls away. The karmic relationships, the soulmates, everything falls away. Okay, but again, it's a personal decision. But from my point of view, I believe in loyalty. I don't think that you can have a relationship with your soulmates or karmics, whatever, and then claim that you are on the twin flame path. No, that is not true. That is not true devotion. True devotion means true devotion. You can't be codependent on the external masculine energy. Then you are true to your twin flame. All right? So this is what I have to say about twin flames today, and I hope you like the video. Okay, see you soon. Bye.